Hello everyone, I am Taureor, and today we're doing tanks only, in Hearts of Iron of course. You guys wanted more challenges, and some of you wanted me to use more variety in my armies, not just infantry. And I hear you, I'm not very familiar with using tanks and the tank designer, because I just don't usually. But let's learn to swim by jumping in at the deep end of the pool, shall we? I'm going to play as Germany, my goal is to defeat the Soviet Union, on historical focuses so there's no civil war making it easier, and I can only use tanks in combat. Well, and support companies. But the main fighting force has to be tanks. I'll be making infantry for stuff like Sudetenland, but we're not allowed to use them in combat. Is that a good idea? No. But is it going to be fun for me? Also no. But some of you do like watching me suffer, so let's try it, shall we? Germany, regular difficulty, Ironman mode, historical focuses. Let's go. I suppose one of the obvious ways to win in this would be to oppose Hitler and then create a pan-European alliance against the Soviet Union, but that would be a bit too easy, because they would likely defeat the Soviet Union for me. So we're going with Rhineland and staying with Adolf. We start with the Panzer Division, I'll have to remove the motorized infantry from it, and we have a pretty decent light tank that we're using from the start. It is pretty expensive though. I think there are two ways we could go about it. Make an elite force of superb, awesome tanks and rely on our allies to hold the line while we use the superb, awesome tanks to cut through the enemy. Or we could make cheap, crappy tanks and just give one to every soldier. With the German industry, it might be feasible to do so. For now though, let's keep producing some support equipment, some trucks, not a lot, cancel the tactical bombers, keep some CAS and fighters. This should be an adequate amount of infantry weapons and max out the tanks. I think we should go into Austria immediately, so let's do Anschluss second focus, which is pretty easy to do. Rhineland first, train as many of these cavalry brigades as we can with all our troops, detach the tanks because we're going to be using those, the rest we switch to the cavalry brigade. We'll lose the experience, but it doesn't really matter because I'm not going to be using these anyway, which gives me the equipment so I can train these faster, also prioritize them. I should probably use maintenance companies with this. And while we have the methyl bills, let's make some military factories. Speed the game up, unpause, let's go. This is why I changed all my units to the cavalry brigade. I can have all that equipment. Now we can change them back to the biggest template we have, the motorized infantry. Why am I doing all these shenanigans? Because Anschluss and Sudetenland and all these here actually demand a lot of manpower in the field, so we have to maximize that. Deploy as soon as we can, and switch them to motorized. It doesn't matter that they have no experience or no equipment, what matters is that they're technically soldiers in the field. See, we already have enough manpower to do Anschluss. Oh yeah, let's get the Dutch as well, why not? And hire the silent workers. And make a spy agency. See, next focus, Anschluss. Mechanical computing. Immediate flip to free trade. It boosts everything, research, construction, and even factory output. Cryptology, and get me a Soviet spy. We have 900,000 manpower in the field right now, and we've done the Anschluss. Article accept, of course they are. Work conditions, boost the artillery, let's do these industrial things, even though they're a bit ahead of time. And looks like I have enough army experience to create a tank variant. I've decided to try and go with the crappy tank, but loads and loads of them, so that every soldier can have one. Our current design is this. Pretty decent. And if we go down on armor, engines, remove the radio, switch to a one-man turret, and get the cheapest but tracked suspension, I guess I'll keep the autocannon. Heavy machine gun reduces attack too much. Mostly concerned with soft attack, I'd go with a close support gun, but it's a bit expensive. We could go with non-tracked suspension, but this reduces hardness quite significantly, so that's not. So I guess I'll do that, but as a new design, because it's going to be cheaper that way. Oh yeah, and the diesel engine, because it's more reliable, and I don't care about speed that much. Blasphemy, I know. Alright, let's not forget, extra ammunition storage reduces our reliability a little bit, but our reliability is already high, and we can get extra defense and breakthrough from it for zero extra cost. Let's do that. More. That's pretty good stats for such a cheap tank, I think. The cheapo. Best model. This looks cool, but I think this looks much cuter. Let's use this one. Alright, that's our tank. Let's switch to it so we can have more. Yes, I know they're crappier, but I think it's gonna be worth it if everyone is in a tank, even if they're not very good tanks. Of course, this is all my assumptions, which might be wrong. We will see. Unit conference, yay, give me Sudetenland. I think it might be time to get Yugoslavia. Why in this order? I think once we get Sudetenland, fate of Czechoslovakia is decided already, but fate of Yugoslavia is not. So if we go for Yugoslavia right now, I should be able to still get it. Also, I think I'm gonna try and befriend Poland. Not sure if I'm doing the right thing prioritizing military factories while we have the methyl bills. We will need a ton of oil to operate this many tanks, but I can just do it by buying it from the allies, if I don't plan to attack them, and I don't. War economy. They're being built pretty damn fast. Triumph for Germany. We're not getting a lot of territory from this, but we can push this to get all of Yugoslavia. I'm gonna improve relations with them. I don't think it affects the outcome, but I don't really want to check, and it might. And if not, let's just call it role-playing. Let's try and turn Poland to our side. Beating machine and concentrated too. Oh, right, the Spanish Civil War. Let's send some volunteers. Now, I remember watching a feedback video. He said it's better to send them to Republican Spain. I don't remember why, but I'm just going to trust him on this. And go up to 6. All right, 6 units of panzer divisions. Now, in order to use them in combat, I should switch them to light tanks. And I don't have the army experience for it, which is very unfortunate. Let's hire the offense expert. He's going to give us some army experience so we can switch the tanks over. Fate of Yugoslavia. Although he's probably giving us more army experience than we would get from the volunteers. But let's send them anyway. And make them elite so they get all the supplies. We only have enough tanks to make half an army of only tanks. Fate of Yugoslavia. Do not puppet Yugoslavia, because there is weirdness. Could make a Croatian puppet, but let's try and annex all of it. Oh, excellent. Methyl bills got cheaper, though I still have second thoughts about it. Greece usually doesn't work. I don't remember the specifics on the event, but let's not waste our time. First Vienna World, 30 tanks a day. Rudolf Hess is gonna run away, so let's not take him. But Goebbels, yes, we'll use him. Spanish gold. My volunteers have arrived. There you go. Train up a bit. Fate of Czechoslovakia. Chinese United Front happens. And Hindenburg. Also, another Soviet spy when we get the option. And more Dutch trade. Do you think I can use railway guns? I would count that as a support unit, so let's say yes. Fate of Czechoslovakia. We get everything, please. We got a lot of territory, a lot of factories. Now let's try to befriend Poland, Danzig for Slovakia, and we improve relations with them. Once again, not sure if that's necessary, but it feels like the right thing to do. In retrospect, I probably should have cancelled the methyl bills immediately and started with some civilian factories. Because if we went into industrial concern and got all the advisors we want, I think we would have benefited more. They're fighting my fascist influence. Let's do Dora. Right, Danzig for Slovakia. Do you accept? Please accept. Excellent. It means path is open to us to befriend Poland. Let's do professional officer call. Meticulous preparation. Now, we're employing crappy slow tanks, so increased speed wouldn't really do that much, I think. 10% reliability is tempting, but I think we'll be better off with soft attack and reliability boosts. We definitely want the advanced light tank after we get a bonus to it. We might also want the medium one later. In all honesty, I'll probably stick to light tanks, but just to have the option. Would you like to be in my faction? Oh, you would. Need more world tension. Nice. Cool. Let's do the army innovations thingy. If we can now build an alliance with Poland, Romania, Hungary, Italy, possibly Bulgaria, that will be a nice wall against the Soviet Union. And the methyl bills are running out. It's their time to go. Finish these factories you're already building, and then we'll need some civilian ones. Improved computing. We're actually making 70 tanks a day. How are my tanks in Spain? Whoa! They're doing terribly, and they're dying all around. I don't think I can save them. I could go with maneuver warfare, but I think flexible organization is going to help us more. Not sure, but the organization loss when moving seems very useful when you're in the offensive. Methyl bills paid off. Let's boost our guns a bit. Our last tank. Sending tanks as volunteers and then not paying attention to them was probably the wrong move. German-Soviet treaty. Nice. Ah, I lost my last volunteer. Lesson, don't send volunteers if you're not going to pay attention to them. Let's get the Prince of Terror. Bulgaria approaches me, apparently. I've researched everything I want which isn't ahead of time. So let's go ahead of time. On the industry first. Let's make those railway guns. 10 should suffice. An entire army group. Switch them all to the panzer divisions. And we almost have enough tanks for them. Perhaps I should be using logistics companies. Yes, they do help with fuel. I probably should. Let's do anti-combatant pack. Time to use our bonus to get a better light chassis. Blitzkrieg theorist. Get boosting. Go the Blitzkrieg route. 4-year plan. What did the Bulgarians want again? Sure, let's recognize their claims. Shall not invest in Turkey. Schwerpunkt. Let's do anti-Soviet pact, and I don't remember who this actually involves exactly. Concentrated 4, because we can. We formalize anti-Soviet pact. Grossraum Wirtschaft. We have enough tanks for everybody. Nice. Armor genius. Align Romania. We want them in our faction. Logistics expert. Zorks amidst Italy. God damn it. I selected the fleet logistics expert while I wanted to select the army logistics expert, which is a bit silly of me. Italy pursues closer bonds. Yes, you can join the faction. Align Hungary. No, Romania is not fascist enough. Well, you will be. Let's do a coalition government on the Soviet Union. Become the spy master of our own faction. Blitzkrieg. Artillery designer. Rheinmetall. We can invite Romania or Hungary. Oh, nice. Well, Romania, you first. Hungary, are you still interested? Yes. Excellent. Now I'm going to make you my puppets. You've joined war against Ethiopia for some reason. And Ethiopia is allied with the Allies. Why? You're not being called in, or they can't call them in. You know what? Not my problem. Integrate war economies. We're going to make Romania and Hungary my puppets. We'll get a nice source of fuel for our tanks. Advanced light tank chassis. Should we switch our cheapo to that? We use the advanced chassis. Well, that's some very high reliability, even with the extra ammunition. Cost increase is not that high. We do get extra armor. Let's save this design and compare. The cheapo 2. Yeah, we get much higher reliability and some more armor. The cost increase is not that big. We might put a better cannon on it a bit later. Now let's switch to the cheapo 2. Fuel refining 3. Army regrouping guy, please. Integrate war economies. Do you accept? Accept and accept. Excellent. We now have subjects. Yes, Italy, I would like some stuff. Time for autarky. Though, probably I should have started with that. Yeah, I should have started with autarky and done all the political decisions later. It would have been fine. See, when you're in Germany, the world tension seems to be very low for some reason, if you're not attacking people. Oh, goddammit. Making Romania and Hungary puppets has actually called me into the war against Ethiopia. Oh well, let's create an empty thingy with just one horse. We're gonna use that for having troops for conversions and such. How are we doing on equipment? Actually fine on artillery, okay-ish on anti-air, not enough support equipment. Yeah, definitely should have started with these. Hermann Göringwerke and atomic research for faster research. How do you dominate Dutch trade negotiations? I had a huge lead on you. Finally decided to do something about that. I mean, the Dutch are not that important for my plans, but a little bit more is nice. Oh, the Soviets have taken Lithuania. Soviet-German trade agreement. Sure, that can be useful. Latvia also surrendered, even though we had the anti-Soviet pact. That surprises me. Thought they would have resisted. I kept them able to cave to us for 4 years, maybe. Well, 3 at least. And they haven't. Now they're probably gonna cave to the British immediately. Oh, they're actually supporting the British themselves, so what I'm doing now is wasting political power. Let's ignore them. Yeah, I know, we've wasted some political power, but it's not that important. We have a lot of it. Instead, let's do anti-democratic and anti-communist raids, thus decreasing our stability so we can improve working conditions, which will bring our stability way over 100%. Do we want Himmler in the field? No. This just ticked up twice, which means not only the Brits are investing, the Dutch are also leaning towards the Brits, which means I cannot win this. Boost our artillery a bit. We have enough equipment for everybody. And 2 collaboration governments. Successful. Yeah, Netherlands caved to the British. Probably should have expected that since I did select historical focuses. Oh, Finland rejects the Soviets. We could probably intervene. The Baltic countries are gone. I suppose I'll garrison my ports with tanks, which seems a bit wasteful. But oh well. Soviet Union attacks Finland. Do we want to help them? Can we help them? Even if I wanted to, they don't want my help for some reason. Well, that's fine then. You do you, Finland. Extensive conscription, please. We can get an improved automatic cannon from this. Reset slot. I was actually expecting the Soviets to move against Romania earlier. I probably should have gone for the extra research slot first, and then done all the diplomatic stuff. This should be good, provided my idea with the crappy tanks is not terrible. White peace for Finland. The Soviets are just fine on Poland, very slowly. Might be doing the ultimatum focus too. Let's get ready. Let's get these guys to the Polish border, so they can get to Poland quickly to help Poland, which is a weird thing for Germany to do. If I were to give you a better gun, the increase in price is still not that great. It's still cheaper than the base light tank I had at the start of the game. Of course, the base light tank was faster. Improved automatic cannon, please. Cheapo 3. Switch that, it's slightly better. Reichsautobahn. Hey, Romania, my nice little subject, give me your fuel. Well, good thing I'm only building civilian factories for now. I'll need more for oil. They attacked Greece. Are you allied with someone? No, you're not. Good. On the one hand, I'm happy I had enough time to prepare myself, and the Soviet Union has not made any moves against Romania. On the other hand, I'm disappointed I have not invested in autarky faster in that case. Do we want the Triparty Pact? No. Spending 42 civilian factories on trade for fuel right now. But we do have enough. Soviet Union declared war on Poland, and Bulgaria seeks to join the Axis. Yes, you can join the Axis, and I think it's go time, because we do have a pact with Poland. Let's ask them for military access immediately, even before we're called to war. Oh, I think they'll be joining the Allies. Not a problem. So what do? We stop the exercise, get that access from Poland. So why have I not been called in? Poland joins the Allies. Ah, they call the pact members to war. Yes, let's. I'm not exactly ready in position, but I will be in a moment. So, it's go time. Activate orders and let's see. How well are you going to do in the cheapos? Activate your orders. Actually, pretty well. Thought this was a terrible idea, but it sure doesn't look like it. Let's let them get in position, then we call Romania in. Formalize the alliance. Yeah, do that. This is looking beautiful. Now I do have to spend a lot, and I do mean a lot, of factories on buying fuel. But while we're not at war with the Allies, it's not that bad. Let's call everyone in. Alright, let's see. Attack. And we are on balanced. But I actually did not expect to be doing so well with just crappy tanks. Should I go super aggressive? Let's go super aggressive and just see where this takes us. Alright, let's see this battle. Low supply. Those are quite decent amounts, and we shouldn't be taking too much damage because we have armor, and they probably don't have a lot of heart attack. We did sustain some losses, back to balanced, because we're losing some people here. Doing better on balance than on aggressive, and I should definitely have added logistics companies. Modern Blitzkrieg. Running out of support equipment. Still have enough tanks. Attacking over a river. I do have engineers, don't I? Yes, so it shouldn't be too bad. Suppose I could do amphibious tanks. Romania rejects Soviet demands. Yes, of course it does. Now, casualties are still high. I expected the tanks to actually protect our people a bit more than this. Panzer expert. And panzer expert. And panzer expert. Italy sends stuff, sure. This is not going well. But it's also not going terribly. I actually expected it to go terribly. Like artillery only or something. And we ran out of tanks. Should I go to cautious? No. Here's what you have. Keep attacking. I'll give military access to the Allies. Maybe they'll go into Poland and help them a bit. Not going too well, is it? Yeah, running out of my crappy tanks. Perhaps it was the wrong choice to go with the cheapo. Although it seemed very promising. And we did make nice progress at the start. How about I go aggressive? Just so we keep attacking with what we have. We do have armor and some breakthrough. Probably should have gone with the other option of making elite tanks. Oh, wonderful. We got roped into the war with Ethiopia and suddenly I'm at war with the Allies for some reason. And I have lost all my tanks. A lot of preparation for nothing. Well, it's definitely not what I expected, but I think we have our answer. Also, Poland, who we have been helping, has now betrayed us. Let's do a desperate move. Put them on Poland, which won't work. Why on Poland? Because we have been nice to them and they betrayed us. Alright, we're gonna get defeated. Haven't experienced that in a bit, but let's let this happen. I suppose we've earned it. What is the conclusion? Tanks only is a terrible experience. Like any insert equipment here only, I suppose. May it be with the exception of infantry, because infantry can hold its own in any situation. But what else have we learned today? Actually, I've learned how to use the tank designer, so that's something. But I've also learned that giving everyone a tank and just calling it a day, even if the tanks are crap, and even if you give them full fuel, is not enough to win. Yeah, I suppose I could have designed better tanks, but then they would be more expensive, and I wouldn't be able to make this many. So, are tanks crap? No. But they do require a firm front line. They need the support of infantry. Am I going to use tanks more from now on? I think so, yeah. But only as they should be used, as elite forces to attack important points. I could mix them with motorized infantry, and this probably would have worked fine if I did so. And I might still do. Let me know if you would like to see motorized infantry and tanks, although motorized infantry in itself is very powerful. But one thing I will probably do is, going forward, if I have an industrially powerful country like Germany or the Soviet Union or the United States, I will likely incorporate some advanced high-quality tanks to break enemy resistance. So I will try to do what many of you have asked me to do and introduce some more variety to my units. Not always, because it is not always prudent and not all countries can afford to do it. We've captured someone and also I have capitulated. Let's end it here with our clear verdict. Tanks only are terrible. Thank you for watching. I think I'll go back to doing more challenges. So let me know in the comments what you would like to see. And that's it for today. Enjoy your prize, France and Poland, and I'll see you again soon. Goodbye.